I think the first thing I would caution you to do is, instead of defining what civil rights meant for, nobody is suggesting that we need to stay with segregated systems, and nobody is, I'm not suggesting, certainly.
It sounded like.
Well, I'm clarifying, so if you want to hear what I have to say, I'll continue to talk. I think it's always dangerous when some of us in the majority declare how it should be and define whether we've gotten better or not. In some ways, I think we have, in some ways, we haven't. The reality is, the data shows that since the civil rights movement, African Americans own less land in this country. The data shows that the prisons are filled with brown and black people.
This is interesting.
Bottom line, to the point that, you know, capitalism is just kind of carried on. So, I'm not suggesting that, but we can sit around and talk. Unification sounds fine. But what does it really mean? Who's going to pay the price? Who's going to be included in the discussion? What are the consequences going to be? So, yeah, and I get this a lot from my white brothers and sisters. We want to tell black folks how much better it is. I think that in itself is a racist act. We need to be talking with one another and listening to one another. I don't tell women breast cancer to admit, even though I have never experienced it. So nobody is suggesting that the policies were necessarily a failure or that we need to go back, but there's also the reality that when I talk to black elders in this community, they remember a different experience about segregated schools with all their problems. Some of them can speak to that for themselves. They were taught by people that loved it, that didn't criminalize it. They were taught history that reflected their participation in this country. Those schools were in their community, so when something went wrong, their teachers.